Hey guys, Trey here, and today I want to talk about audio alignment in the new version of Cubase, Cubase 10. So for the most part, I don't try to sell people on the DAW that I use, Cubase 10. I prefer people just to decide what they like, figure out what you want to buy, get used to. I do use a lot of things that are native to Cubase in some of my videos, but I often try to show you that there are other alternatives besides the Cubase native options. And that's because what I do here, I want you to know that it's doable in any digital recording system. But today I really want to do hats off to Steinberg's Cubase, because before the end of the year, they released the new version, version 10, and several of the improvements and additions to the program are just really amazing. And the one feature I want to talk about today is audio alignment, which they've now included inside the DAW. So here we go. So until Cubase version 10, the way I aligned audio was I used a program called VOCALS. One of the downsides of using it in Cubase and so many DAWs was that you have to actually run your audio through the plugin in real time. And then once you've done that, you align it. You click align, you check it out to make sure it's all aligned. Then you have to bounce the file down or export it back into your system so that you have an aligned file. And that is time consuming. And sometimes with a session with a lot of vocal tracks, that could take me hours to go through and align everything. And I had to run it line by line. Once in a while, I would try to run Vari Audio in several parts at once. The results were not always successful. So line by line, real time running, having to export, all that stuff took a lot of time. With Cubase 10, the audio alignment tool allows you to apply the alignment directly to the file. You don't have to export or bounce. You can do multiple files, and you can do a bunch of other cool things as well that I want to show you today. So let me run through it with you. So the song I have up is a song that we did with Kaya Stewart about 3 years ago. So first of all, let me play you the final so you can hear what it sounds like, and then we'll talk about the alignment. Okay, so this song was written with Kaya, SJ Jones, Gina Schock, myself. Great song. I love Kaya's voice. The second pre-chorus has got quite a stack of vocals on it right here. So let me play this for you. Okay, so what we're looking at here is I've got my lead, I've got two doubles, then I've got a stack of three harmonies here, and then I've got an octave below the lead. So pretty good stack. So now I'm going to go back to the original file before I did the audio alignment. Okay, so right now we're looking at my session before I align the vocals. And one of the first things I noticed when I pulled this up was probably the last of the vocal files in this section that I aligned were the harmony twos left and right. And the reason I know that is because I'm looking at my lead, which of course I used that to align to, and I actually had to pull out part of the lead here. I would cut the lead vocal so that it only plays where my harmony comes in. If I tried to just let the lead vocal play across the harmonies, vocal line had a tough time sometimes catching the beginning of the first syllable of the harmony and it would tweak it really weirdly. So this is what I would have to do in order to make that work. And again, with Vocaline, for each one of those tracks, I'd have to go in, I'd have to, on the insert channel, I would put an instance of Vocaline, and I would put it in capture mode, and play through. Once I played it, I would align it by hitting edit, and then I would check it, and sometimes I'd have to do it a couple of times if I had weird breaths or things that were throwing a syllable off. So let me show you how it works now in Cubase. The first thing I have to do when I'm aligning audio is I'm still right now working with my comped tracks. For instance, in this lead vocal, you see that I have several sections. These were all different takes that we did when we originally tracked the vocal. So the first thing I do is render those files so that they are all individually one long audio track. And all I have to do is hit this. So that part of the process takes about 40 seconds. You'll see that once I have my new audio in place here, it just mutes the original so I can see the files that I'm working with. Then I click right here and open up my audio alignment tool. What you're seeing here referenced, that's the track that you want to align to, and the targets are all those tracks you want to align. So the first thing I do is just click on this file, hit plus here, and it immediately drops that pre-lead right here. All right, the next thing I do is just grab all of these files. There you go. And now hit plus there, and it includes all of them there. I'm still working with these two settings. So far for me, I've just been using mainly match words, which provides the best results for identical wording. So I keep that checked. I have been using the alignment precision as 100%. I haven't found that it created any unusual anomalies. Hit audio align. There you go. Let's check it soloed. We'll stay up all night to... Okay, right there I heard something. Night was a little rough in some spots. Up there, let's hear it with the audio alignment. We'll stay up all night together. Still hear night. Don't tell me to stop. But overall, a really fantastic job on the alignment. So let's look at the individual tracks and see what might need some tweaking. So with Cubase, you'll notice that one of the things you see on all these files here, this is my lead, so you don't see it up here, but on all these other files, you're going to see this little symbol right here at the end of the tracks. This is indicating that right now it's in essentially audio warp mode or audio alignment mode. So let's look at this track right here. Right now, because it's in that mode, you'll see over here under audio warp, this little orange indicator suggests that it's in audio alignment mode. That means it's got markers for the different syllables. If I want to move those around, I can go here to free warp and I can actually just shift them. So what this allows me to do is if something hasn't quite aligned perfectly with the alignment tool, I can go back in and quickly manually adjust while it's still in that mode. And I'm not looking for perfection, mind you, but I'm definitely looking for words that are way out. We'll stay up all night. Okay, right here, the first one that's kind of bugging me is night. This is one of those harmony twos. It catches it pretty well for the most part on this one, harmony two right, but harmony two left, because you have this rolling syllable into the word from the lead, it doesn't quite catch the left side of harmony two. Once it hits the sort of plosive part of the syllable, not bad, but right here, this little section, I want to kind of rein that in a little. If you look at this up here on my top file, I just kind of find the beginning of that syllable, that plosive moment where I really want it to kick in. This one right here, we're going to bring this little section in line. So I'm going to go right there. It sort of automatically lines up to where my cursor is, which is about at bar 42 here. And this is the section that I want to bring in. So all I'm going to do is grab right here. Now you'll notice something that's happening that's not useful. while I'm pushing this in, it's backing the main part of the syllable off. So even though there's no specific marker here, I can just grab anywhere I want to with my warp tool. I'm going to grab right here at the edge of this sort of plosive moment in the syllable. I'm going to drag it in a little bit and see if we can't make this a little tighter. So now those are lined up. If I look at the main file now, we don't hear that knife that's sticking way out front there. Let me just quickly mute these. See what we did to it. See how it actually sounds, because that was a pretty radical edit. And that's fine. So that cleans that up nicely. But look at the one right below it. Not bad. It's really actually reasonable, but I'm going to fix it just for the sake of showing how simple this is. If I want to, I've got a couple here. I've got one right here on my first double, this blue one. I'm going to pull that in a little bit. I'm going to tighten that up. I'm going to tighten this second harmony here, right side. It's in the red. We're going to tighten that one up first. Again, we just go right over here. I'm just going to kind of pull that up a little bit. Nice. Same thing for this one. Let's pull this up a little bit. There you go. Up all night together. Let me check one thing I just heard there. Okay, right here. I'm going to pull this up just a little bit. Let me make sure I did that right. Yeah, that's actually not too bad. Let me go a little bit tighter with it. That should be good. And if I really want to get picky, I could slide the one right above it back a little bit. I could take both of these right here, both of these, slide them back just a little bit. And again, I probably wouldn't do this. I'm just doing it for demonstration right now, but I don't think these are far enough off to really make that big a deal. I want the vocal to feel more natural. But truthfully, the more stacks of vocals you have together, the more they start to sound messy if anything's out of alignment. So it really is important to take a look at that stuff. So the last thing you want to do after you align your files, these files, they're still in audio warp or audio alignment mode, which means that the system is referring back to the original unaligned files, and it's processing that alignment in real time, which of course is CPU intensive, it's eating power. So once you've got your files the way you want them, you just need to, in Cubase, you just need to flatten. You can go into the real-time processing, hit flatten real-time processing, saves the processing to the file, you're done. All right. There you go. So this to me is a major time saver. It works so well. It's so intuitive. I haven't heard any weird artifacts. It just feels like it does a great job, does it very efficiently. All right, you guys, hope you enjoyed this. Hope you learned something from it. And if you did, of course, please like, please subscribe. And until next time.